by welcoming our special guest of honor, the Executive Governor of New York State, His Excellency Barrister Suleiman Jimeh, who has graciously accepted to honor our invitation. At the forum like this, it is pertinent to recognize the significant transformation that has been brought to New York State under the able leadership of His Excellency, particularly in the areas of infrastructure improvement, economic empowerment, agriculture, and tourism development, as well as improvement in healthcare and education sectors. Your Excellency, sir, we appreciate and commend your efforts and all you to keep up the good work while we continue to pray for the success of your administration. Distinguished ladies and gentlemen, our gathering here is underscored by the increasing importance and relevance of trade to global development. The World Trade Organization, that is WTO, in its latest report, intimated that the contribution of trade to the gross domestic product increased from about 40% in 1980 to about 60% today. This increase was driven mainly by Asia, which contributed about 28% of global trade in 2010, and rapidly catching up with Europe and America. Unfortunately also, Africa, in spite of its huge natural resource endowments and position of over 60% of the world's total uncultivated arable land, accounts for only about 3% of the global trade and remains a net importer of food. The story of Nigeria mirrors the African situation. Nigeria imports about $10 billion worth of food annually, while total non-oil seed was only $3.15 billion in 2011. Even with the huge oil seed, which increased to $90.12 billion in 2011, overall balance of payment deficit, according to Central Bank of Nigeria statistics, averaged 3.61% over the last 3 years in view of the rising import bills. Ladies and gentlemen, the point of emphasis here is that over dependence on oil by Nigeria, besides exposing the country to the vagaries of the external market, has remained a limiting factor in achieving our full growth potential. Having recognized this, the federal government under the Vision 2020 program and the recent transformation agenda of Mr. President now seeks to achieve double-digit growth for the country through the diversification of Nigeria's economy and promotion of value-added exports. The transformation agenda of Mr. President, which is an all-inclusive program, also requires states and local government to develop key sectors of their local economies in line with the national objectives. It is against the background of the foregoing that the theme of today's event, the transformation agenda, promoting non-oil export as a strategy for job and wealth creation, has become very apt. Like every other agency of government, the Nigeria Export-Import Bank has played a very major role in contributing towards the achievement of the transformation agenda. As you may all be aware, the bank was established in January 1991 as the official export credit Development Agency and the Sole Trade Policy Bank of the Federal Government of Nigeria, charged with the mandate of promoting the diversification of the Nigerian economy through the provision of finance, risk-bearing facilities, and policy support to the non-oil export sector. Since its inception, the bank has cumulatively disbursed over 73 billion naira and $322 million. If you gross it up in naira, you are talking about over 85 billion naira in support to over 900 export projects in the real sector, mostly small and medium scale enterprises, thereby creating and sustaining over 300,000 direct jobs, in addition to many indirect jobs, and generating over $1.2 billion in foreign exchange earnings for the country. Given our efforts to develop the high growth sectors and increase employment generation in the country, NEXIM now is focusing on four non-oil sectors, which we believe have very high growth potentials in terms of creating jobs for Nigerians, generating foreign exchange for the economy. So we are focusing on manufacturing, agro-processing, solid minerals, and services. Under the services sub-sector, we are looking at financing tourism, that is our case. We are looking at financing transportation, both roads, A and C. And then we are looking at financing creative and entertainment industry. In the process, we have recently developed a funding program for the creative and entertainment industry, in addition to a special scheme for SME exporters in the ECOWAS region. We'll be talking more about these and other NEXIM products during the technical session. Distinguished participants, our decision to host this forum in the Southeast is informed by the huge potentials of the region in contributing to the national agenda. The Southeast region, made up of five states, including Abia, Anambra, Ebonyi, Enugu, and Imo, is the home of Igbo people, who are well known for their strong entrepreneurship spirit. The region has very strong antecedents as a major driver of economic activities in Nigeria, with huge agricultural output, producing cash crops like palm oil, rubber, and cashew, in addition to its solid minerals endowment. Besides oil and gas, the region has about 25 solid minerals in commercial quantities, mostly underdeveloped, and part of the region has been identified as a tropical rainforest cluster that is under the World Tourism Calendar. The Southeast is also well positioned to contribute towards increased value-added export, given the activities of small-scale manufacturing industries within the region. Newe is regarded as the Japan of Africa in view of its industrial significance, producing items like cosmetics, vehicle parts, textiles, electronic cables, etc. The Iberia market in Abba has grown to become the major hub for the manufacture of leather products such as shoes and bags, which form the bulk of cross-border trade among neighboring countries. Onitsha is also a trade hub, and together with Enugu has become the major center for the production of movies in the fast-growing Bollywood industry. Indeed, if we harness, the Southeastern region has the potential to become a major hub for the export of value-added products by Nigerian SMEs. Distinguished ladies and gentlemen, one of the key objectives of NEGI in organizing this event is to explore possible areas of collaboration and synergies with exporters and small-scale producers in this region. We have observed that despite its endowments and export potentials, the region has not fully achieved its potentials. It is expected that a forum like this will create opportunity for us to bridge any information gap and assist the region through funding interventions and other governmental and capacity building initiatives. Distinguished participants, in order to address other affected issues affecting the non-oil export sector, we have also invited other distinguished speakers to discuss relevant topics in line with the theme. In this regard, ladies and gentlemen, let me to please join me in welcoming Andy D. and the Putin of the Nigerian Export Promotion Council, Margaret Aces of Standard Organization of Nigeria, M.M. Muga of Nigerian Institute for Oil Palm Research, and Comrade Ken Anyao, who is from the Association of Leather and Allied Industries of Nigeria. We have expressed our appreciation to these organizations for their kind acceptance to participate in this enlightenment drive. This, we pray and hope, is the opening of a new chapter in our common efforts to improve our national economy and promote private development of our country. Especially is of honor, distinguished senator, all invited guests, gentlemen of the press, once again, I warmly welcome you to this event and wish all of us fruitful celebrations. Thank you very much.
Thank you, Mr. Robertson. Thank you, sir. So, without wasting more time, we're getting straight into the